Welcome to this lecture where we will solve the first and last index problem. We are given a sorted array of integers r and an integer target, and we are asked to find the index of the first and last position of target in r. If target can't be found in r, return -1, -1. For example, if r is 2, 4, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 7, 9, 9 and target is 5, the output would be 2, 6, because the first position of target is 2 and its last position is 6. First of all, because the array is sorted, all the elements with the same value will be adjacent to each other. For example, here all positions of the value 5 are consecutive. It means that the first possible solution is to start traversing the array from the beginning, find the first position of target, and keep walking until finding the last position. With our example, we have 2, 4, then 5. We found the first position. We keep walking. We have 5, 5, 5, 5. This one is the last one. We found the end position. We return them. In code, we start traversing indexes of r. And if r of I is equal to target, it means that we found the start position. Now we keep walking while the next element exists and is equal to target, while I plus 1 is smaller than length of r, and r of I plus 1 is equal to target. We increment I. After the while loop, I now represents the position of the last occurrence. This is why we return start I. And if the for loop ends without having returned a result, it means that we didn't find target in R at all. We return -1, -1. Note that it's possible to have start position equal to end position. It happens when there is only one occurrence of target in R. For the time complexity, when target exists, we traverse the part before its first position, then its sequence of occurrences. And when it doesn't, we traverse the whole array. In both cases, we traverse at most n elements, where n is the number of elements of r, we get a time complexity of O of n. And a constant space complexity, because we're just using int variables. This solution uses linear search, which gave an O of n time complexity. But the array is sorted, so we can think of using binary search. Let's try to use binary search to find the start position. With binary search, we can find the position of an element in a sorted array, but here, we're not searching for any position of target, we're searching for the first one. I is the first position of target if r of I is equal to target, obviously, but also, r of I minus 1 has to be smaller than target, smaller because the array is sorted. So we will use binary search normally, but we add that second condition before returning mid. Let's try it with our example. Left and right, start at first and last element of R as usual. Mid is left plus right divided by 2. We get 4 here. It's true that R of 4 is equal to target, but it's not enough. R of 4 minus 1 is not smaller than target, so mid is not the starting position of target. But should we go to the left part or to the right part now? R of mid is not greater than target, so the first position can only be in the left part. We continue. Mid is now 0 plus 3 divided by 2. We get 1. R of 1 is smaller than target, so the starting position can only be in the right part. We continue. Mid is now 2 plus 3 divided by 2, which is 2. R of mid is equal to target, and R of mid minus 1 is smaller than target. So mid represents the first position of target. We return it. In code, we can first have an early exit condition for the case where the first element is equal to target. We directly know that 0 is the starting position. We return 0. By the way, in solutions based on binary search, put as much early exit conditions as possible to handle edge cases and avoid out-of-bounds problems. After it, we initialize left and right at 0 and n-1 respectively. 0 and n-1 are the indexes of the first and last element of R. Now, while left is smaller than or equal to right, we calculate mid index. It's left plus right divided by 2. After it, we have three cases. The case where both conditions are respected, where R of mid is equal to target and R of mid minus 1 is smaller than target. It means that mid is the starting position. We return it. Second case, R of mid is smaller than target. It means that we're still before the starting position. This is why we take left to mid plus 1 to start again in the right part. Else, it means that we exceeded the consecutive sequence or we're inside it but not at the beginning. So start can only be in the left part. We take right to mid minus 1. And if the while loop didn't return a result, it means that target doesn't even exist in R. We return minus 1. Now we found the start index, but we still need to find the end index. We can think of just walking starting from start until we find the last position of target, but it would ruin everything we did, because in the worst case, we need to traverse the whole array, which results in an O of n time complexity, same as the first solution. You guessed it, to find the end index, we will also use binary search. But the condition is a bit different from the first time. When searching for the start position, R of mid had to be equal to target and R of mid minus 1 smaller than target. And for the end position, R of mid has to be equal to target and R of mid plus 1 has to be greater than target. Next element has to be greater because it would mean that from the right, we're not in consecutive target elements anymore, so the actual position is the last position of target. In code, we just change a few things. The early exit condition occurs now when the last element is equal to target. It means that the last position of target is in the last index of R, n minus 1, with directly return. Then in the three cases, the case where we return mid is when R of mid is equal to target and R of mid plus 1 is greater than target. For two remaining ones, here when R of mid is greater than target, then we exceeded the consecutive sequence. We go to the left part, right becomes mid minus 1. Else, it means that either we're before the consecutive sequence or we're inside it but not at the end, so end can only be in the right part, left becomes mid plus 1. Now we have our find start function, we have our find end function, we can move to the main solution function. First of all, we have some early exit conditions. We can identify at least three cases where we can't find target at all, when the array has no elements, when target is smaller than the first element, and when target is greater than the last element. In the last two ones, because the array is sorted, we can deduce that target is not equal to all other elements. If at least one of these conditions is true, we directly return minus 1, minus 1. Else, we call find start to get the start position, we call find end to find the end position, and we return start end. If target doesn't exist in R, start and end will have returned minus 1 both. We still get the expected result. For the time complexity, we're using binary search twice, and binary search has an O of log n time complexity because we keep dividing the input size by 2. 2 times O of log n gives an O of log n time complexity. And for the space complexity, we get O of 1 because we're just using int variables. Before ending this lecture, I want to tell you that if you're not comfortable with binary search, you should really work on it because it's a fundamental algorithm technique that appears in many problems like this one, find peak, first bad version, and many other ones. We reached the end of this lecture, I hope that you understood the solutions, and see you in the next one.